How's it going, everyone? It's always good to see you. So I'm going to be really interested to see what the sound in this video sounds like, because for the past few days, I've been making, this is kind of awkward and bulky, but I've been making a whole bunch of these. These are DIY sound absorption panels. They have insulation on the inside. They're 2 feet wide by 4 feet tall, and they're wrapped in fabric, which match the wall color of this room. And so far, I've made 9 of these things, and I've been putting them up around the room. I don't have them everywhere yet, but I've been putting them up. And really, the goal here is just to kill as much reverb and echo as you possibly can to try to enclose the space a bit more so that your voice doesn't echo quite as much when recorded. So I've been making a bunch of panels, and I've been making a bunch of changes to this room, and I'm going to also been upgrading some gear, and so I'm going to be talking about that in a future video. All right, so in this video, I'm going to offer some commentary about one of the more controversial topics in the photography community. Now, we're not talking about politics here. So, I mean, the number of controversial topics that exist in photography are relatively few and somewhat minor. I mean, I guess you can include things like HDR, sky replacement, and you know, whether you should or should not be removing elements from an image, and compositing images and things like that. But the controversial topic that I would like to discuss and offer my opinion on today is the topic of presets. I believe presets are controversial because over the years, I have heard a number of photographers make negative, sometimes even condescending remarks about the use of presets when processing images in Lightroom. Well, to be perfectly blunt, and there's really no better way to say it, I think that's bullshit, and I'm going to explain why. My name is Todd Dominey. I'm a photographer, a designer, and I make videos like this one about photography here on YouTube. A preset is simply a static text file containing saved values for Lightroom's develop panel. There's nothing particularly smart or intelligent about them. I mean, they're just flat files with a bunch of saved values that when you click on them, they apply a particular look, a particular style to your images in Lightroom. I'm sure by now, if you're a Lightroom user, you've probably experimented with them. You've probably downloaded a few free ones from the internet. In the commercial world of presets, I believe there are two main categories. There's no official categorization here, but in my mind, there are two main types. Ones that I would call emulation and creative. Emulation presets emulate the look of film. Now, you'll find a number of people out there selling these types of presets, including Visco, who were one of the earliest people to offer these, to Totally Rad, Really Nice Images, and Maston Labs. These presets modify a digital raw image to look like classic film stocks, including Portra 400, Fuji 400, Ektar, Ilford Black and White. By the way, it's worth pointing out that none of these emulations are exactly the same because there is no science or standard to this. Portra 400, in other words, from one provider, can and will look different from Portra 400, which is created by another. There's a lot of technicality and a lot of hard work that has gone into replicating the look of a particular film stock, but at the end of the day, it's still somewhat subjective. So if you're particularly passionate about a particular film stock, like typically wedding photographers for like Portra or a Fuji 400, sometimes you have to buy each pack to kind of figure out which one you like best. Creative presets, on the other hand, do not emulate film. They may be influenced by some of the characteristics of film, but they're not trying to copy something. They're original, and they have their own unique look and style, which more often than not comes from a photographer's work processing their own photos. It's these creative presets which I believe stir up the most controversy. So why are they controversial? I mean, what's the big deal? Well, because I believe some photographers out there see creative presets as a shortcut, a cheat of sorts. They make it possible for photographers to not have to process their own photos. They can just go out and pay for some other photographer's style, apply that style to their photos, and then pass that style off as their own. I also think some of the criticism stems from the fact that presets can keep people from really delving into and learning the art and the craft of processing raw images. It's a moment in time as part of the photographic process where a photographer typically looks inward to consider, what is the story that they want to tell with the image? What emotion do they want the viewer to feel when looking at the image? That work happens when processing a photo. And if you just use someone else's preset off the shelf, you're not connecting with your photography in a way that is authentic and true to you and your photographic vision. Well, as nice as that may sound, I think for many it's idealistic. I mean, because what if you're not sure what your vision is? What if you don't have a particular style or look to your photography? What if you're new to photo processing and you just don't have the years of experience processing images to know what to do and to know how everything works? So in defense of presets, I believe that it doesn't matter who you are or what creative field you work in, everyone is influenced by the work of others. Oftentimes, it's through the work of others that artists find themselves. Few, if any, creative works are ever created in isolation. And for photography, in my opinion, there is no better way to unpack, deconstruct, and see how looks and styles are achieved than through the use of presets. Because when you apply a preset and then you go into the develop panel, you can see exactly what a photographer did with the tone curve. Maybe they manipulated the RGB curves a particular way. What did they do in HSL? Or what did they do down in that strange nebulous panel known as the camera calibration panel, which, by the way, you can do some really interesting and powerful things with regards to color that are not always possible through the use simply of HSL. But unless you know these things, unless you're able to see it firsthand for yourself and go in and experiment with it and to change their values and to see what effect they have on a photo, it's incredibly hard to learn. So from a learning perspective, I think presets are fantastic and just incredibly valuable. Because even if you don't publish any images with a preset applied, you can at least apply a preset and then go into the develop settings, as I was just talking about, and see how they work and learn something new from them that you can then use in your own processing workflow, in your own journey towards creating a style for your own portfolio of work. So when comparing where I am today with my photo processing compared to where I was a few years ago when I was dependent on presets, I mean, I feel like now I have learned enough from studying and experimenting with all different types of presets and through doing a lot of trial and error and experimentation of my own to be doing my own thing, to be creating a style for myself, which hopefully will give me more consistent and original results. Plus, I mean, I don't know about you, but I genuinely enjoy the process of pulling a photograph out of flat, gray, raw files by hand. I mean, there's just something about it. You know, processing from scratch without presets, it can be frustrating, but it's challenging and yet at the same time so rewarding and satisfying. So in summary, this is the point I want to make. Don't listen to people who speak negatively about presets. Everyone starts off on the ground floor. Everyone needs to be inspired and to be motivated and to learn and deconstruct the work of others in order to find their own voice and to find what works for them and what their style is and what their approach should be in the future with their photography. So in the spirit of that, if you are currently shopping for presets and you're looking to buy some and download some, I have used a bunch of them over the years. There are two in particular that I would highly recommend checking out. The first is Really Nice Images. They sell a large pack of film emulation presets, which deliver great results. If you are looking for classic film looks like Portra 400, Fuji 400, Kodak Ektar, and others, I think it's a preset pack that is definitely worth considering. Second are presets made by photographer Rebecca Lilly. I own a few of her preset packs, and every time she comes out with one, it's guaranteed to be good. She really specializes in soft pastel looks. So they're great for like travel photography and fashion, which, I mean, depending on your subject matter, can look fantastic in the right use case. By the way, to check out both Really Nice Images and Rebecca Lilly, I will leave links to them below in the description. And just for full disclosure, neither one of these people even know about this video. They have not sponsored it or given me presets or anything like that. I've bought presets from both of them over the years, and I just happen to like them a lot. So I would love to hear from you. What are your thoughts about presets? Do you use them? Do you not use them? Do you despise them? Do you love them? Do you have a strong opinion about presets that you would like to share? Please do so below in the comments. If you enjoyed the video, please remember to give it a thumbs up. It really does help. And also subscribe to this channel if you would like to keep in touch with me and see more videos in the future. Thanks so much for being here, everyone. Hope you have a great week. Hope you're doing well. I will see you next time.